This is part two of the video for regrouping mixed numbers so that you can subtract easier.
So Winston wants to make sure that you are super ready to start this video. So you need to have a sheet of notebook paper, and you need to make sure that you have Go Math page 431 practice at the top, and make sure that you have your name in cursive, first and last name, as well as the date and your number before you start this video altogether. So you want to pause and get your page set up and ready to go. Remember, when you're writing a mixed number, you want to write the whole number using two of these spaces, and then their fraction can be written here. So anytime that you're writing a whole number, you want to write the whole number. Winston is helping me out by licking my hands. Sorry, guys. You want to write the whole number with two lines and then your fraction next to it. And also remember that when we're doing subtraction, we want to rewrite that problem going vertically. So pause the video, get your paper set up, and then start the video when you're ready to start the practice. This is some practice and copy from our Go Math workbook. And so let's look at problem number 8, and you'll need a sheet of notebook paper so that you can write this along with myself. So if we're writing 4 and 1/6 subtract 2 and 5/6 in the vertical format, the first thing that we're going to do is look at our fractional part. And I know that 1 take away 5 is impossible, which means I'm going to need to regroup or rename this mixed fraction so that I can have some more in the numerator section to be able to subtract. And this is where I can use that product of taking 1 away and making this a 3 and 6/6. Because remember, we talked about whatever the denominator is, that's gonna be the groups that we're going to use. And now that I have 3 and 3/6, I can add this number to that to create a new or rename a new fraction in the top part. So I'm actually going to be working with 3 and 7/6 because I renamed it, and I'm going to subtract 2 and 5/6. So the new problem then becomes taking a look at 7 take away 5, which is totally possible, and gives me the answer of 2/6. And then I want to look at the whole number, 3 take away 2, which is 1. Now, there becomes the problem of simplification, because I know 2 is a factor of 6. And if 2 is a factor of 6, that means that this fraction can be simplified. So I'm going to go ahead and simplify that by division. And if I divide the numerator, I have to divide the denominator. 2 divided by 2 is 1, and 6 divided by 2 is 3. So that means that my total answer would be 1 1/3, and that's what I would circle. So looking at 4 1/6 is which I started with, and subtracting 2 5/6, my answer becomes 1 1/3. So on my problem up here, I can write 1 1/3, circle that, and know that I'm done. Ready to start with problem number 9, which is 6 9/12 take away 3 10/12. And I'll need to copy that. So on your notebook paper, you'll do it the vertical way, which is 6 9/12 subtract 3 10/12. And we're going to then look at the fractional part first. And I know the numerator 9 cannot be subtract, or you cannot subtract 10 from 9. So 9 take away 10 is impossible, which means I need to regroup or rename this top fraction. So I'm going to take away 1, which leaves me with 5. And I know that if the denominator is 12, that means I have 12/12, and then I'm going to add that 9/12. And that will give me 5 and 21 twelfths. Take away 3 and 10 twelfths. Now I can begin the subtraction with the fractional part. 21 take away 10 is 11. So that's 11 twelfths. And when I look at 5 take away 3, that gives me 2. And as I look at these two numbers, I know 11 and 12 are not factors of each other. So that's the simplified form. So I can go ahead and write my answer of 12 and 11, or I'm sorry, 2 and 11 twelfths at the top. Moving on to number 10, I have 3 and 3 tenths. And I'm going to subtract just 7 tenths. There's no whole number, so I'm going to make sure that I leave that space. And again, I'm going to look at the fractional part first. 3 take away 7 is impossible, so I'm going to regroup. So I know if I take one away, I have 3 and 10 tenths, because my denominator is 10. The one that I'm regrouping or renaming is going to be 10 tenths. And then I'm going to add the 3 tenths to that, which gives me 2 and 13 tenths. And remember, that means this is the same as this. And I can subtract 7 tenths. 13 take away 7 is 6, and the tenth stays the same. And 2 take away nothing is 2. I'm looking at this fraction, and I know that 6 and 10 have factors that are the same. I'm thinking of my factoring tables, and I know that 2 will go into both 6 and 10. So that means I can reduce or simplify this fraction into a smaller number. 6 divided by 2 is 3. 10 divided by 2 is 5. So 3/5 is a smaller fraction, which is the same amount as 6 tenths. So when you simplify, you are not changing anything except to say that 6 tenths, which might look something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 6 tenths, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, is the same as if I had that just with the 5 and I had 3 of those colored in. And I probably did the coloring the wrong way on this. Let me get rid of the coloring this way, and let me show you the coloring in a different format so that you can see how they're the same. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to go along with the 6 tenths. And that is the same as 3/5 because this is 1, 2, and 3. And so you can definitely see that these two are exactly the same. And the way I did that was to dividing both of them by 2. And that gave me my reduced fraction. Now, to take this fraction back and add it with the whole number, my final answer is 2 3/5, which I will add to the top portion so that I have shown my work, but I've also given the answer. Moving on to the last one, which is 4 take away 2 3/5, I'll write down my problem of 4 take away 2 3/5, and I notice immediately that there is no fractional part, so I've got to rename this 4. When I rename the 4, it becomes 3 5/5 because the denominator is 5. So now I can say 5 take away 3, which is 2/5, and 3 take away 2, which is 1. And I know when I look at 2 and 5, there are no common factors between those two. So I know I'm at the end of my problem, and I can add the answer in.
Hope you found these videos and these practices helpful. If you still have questions, please write a sticky note and leave it on my desk so that I can help you out.